This is all that
Jesus Christ, fully God, fully man, crucified for our sins. This is the love of God, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever, red, black, yellow, white, flower-wearing pants guy, that whosoever believes in him should not perish. Sinners like you and I should not perish, meaning go to hell, but have everlasting life, meaning go to heaven under God's grace, mercy, and love forever. This is the love of God in the person of Jesus. Love, love is not blind. Love is not blind because God is holy. There is right, there is wrong, there is good, there is evil, there is heaven, and there is hell. And Jesus came and he spoke the truth. Jesus came, the full manifestation of the grace of God. Jesus came to save sinners.
This is all that matters. Look at your heart.
Yes, sir.
Your heart, my heart, their heart.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You have a great day. God bless.
This is all that matters. This is all
yes, love is all that matters. He has a pen that says love. Love is all that matters. It's true. But what is love? Is it loving for two people to reject the love of God as God defines it? When God says that sex is meant for marriage. And our culture says, hey, sex is meant for anyone who wants to have it. Any consenting adults want to come together and have sex, it's good. That's what our culture says, and we say it's love. And yet here's the problem, is we have consenting adults coming together to have sex, calling it love, and then we have 55 million children aborted. That's the result of violating God's design and God's command and calling it love. It's not love. It's not love. The result of rejecting God's design is death, because the wages of sin is death. Oh, absolutely. I don't want sinners to go to hell. Jesus was so loving that he spoke about hell more than anyone else in the Bible, because he didn't want people to go there, friends. He didn't want people to die in their sins. Thus, he said, I am the way and the truth and the life, and no man comes to the Father but by me, John 14:6. Thus, John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world. Now, you know nothing of God, sir. You have a God that's a figment of your own imagination that you have created. You have created, and you're a God unto yourself, sir. And unless you repent, you'll perish. But the one true God has revealed himself in his word. And he says this, God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Therein is the love of God. In the person of Jesus Christ. Outside of Jesus Christ, there is no grace, there is no mercy, there is no love. If we reject Jesus, we reject the love of God. If we reject Jesus, we reject the grace and mercy and kindness of God. God in his love has made a way of escape. He's made a way of salvation. But it is through Jesus and Jesus alone. For Jesus has the one name under heaven given among men which we must be saved, as Acts 4:12 says. You're right that anything outside of the Word of God is blah, 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 and it's unloving, sir. But because I love these folks, and because God loves them, he would warn them of the certain condemnation to come. For we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, Romans 3:23. And the wages of sin is death, Romans 6:23. But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus. That's Romans 6:23b, the second behalf. And that's the love of God, the gift of God, eternal life in Christ Jesus. But if we reject Jesus Christ, if we reject his cross, if we reject his crucifixion, if we reject his death, his payment for our sins, if we reject the empty tomb, if we reject him as the one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, then we choose to stand on our own two sinful feet before God who is holy, 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 and we will perish. For he will say, go from me, I never knew you, and cast you out into outer darkness with his weeping and gnashing of teeth. So my friends, don't reject the love of God. Don't reject the love of God. Look to the love of God embodied in Jesus Christ. Look to the love of God embodied in the cross. Look to the love of God in the empty tomb. Look to the love of God at the right hand of the Father, as Jesus is the one mediator between God and men. Friends, look to the love of God and be saved. But the love of God is found in the person of Jesus Christ. It's not found in religion. It's not found in the bread and the cup. It's not found in our works. It's not found in a priest. It's not found in the church. It's found in the person of Jesus Christ. Yes, Jesus taught love. Like I said, he loved people so much that he died for our sins so that we don't have to go to hell. He loved people so much that he who is without sin took upon himself our sins to rescue us from the judgment of God. That's the grace of God. That's the mercy of God. That's the love of God, friends, in the person of Jesus Christ. And I appreciate my friend coming out here today to help draw attention to the love of God. For outside of the person of Jesus, there is no love. No, sir. No, sir. No, he's not. No, he's not. But friend, you're angry. I love you. I don't want you to go to hell. I don't want you to go to hell, sir. Look into Jesus and be saved, sir. No one, no Christian following Jesus has ever harmed anyone else in the name of Jesus, sir.
Capital punishment.
There are folks that have abused the name of Jesus. But no, Jesus died for sinners. He didn't kill. He died for sinners. Look to Jesus, sir. I am loving you, sir. I want you to go to heaven. You're not my enemy. I love you. I'm not your enemy. He's not my friend. I don't know. Look to Jesus, sir, and be saved.
Show your kindness and love. Spread it.
I love you, sir. Look unto Jesus. Here's the love of God, that Jesus stretched out his arms to be crucified. No, Buddha died a sinner before a holy God. Buddha was just a man like you and I. Jesus, though, was the Son of God, fully man, born of the Virgin Mary, crucified for our sins, resurrected on the third day, conquering sin and death to save us. Buddha can't save us. Krishna can't save us. Allah cannot save us. There is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, friends. Look unto Jesus Christ, as John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever, red, black, yellow, white, that whosoever believes upon him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Trusting in your own fallen mind and the God you have created is misguided. Trusting in the God who has revealed himself through Holy Scripture, the one true God, that is the true guide, the Scripture, the Word of God. Sir, if you follow your own path, you'll perish. He brings up a good point. Many people are following their own path. But Jesus said this. Hear the words of Jesus. "The thief comes to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I," says Jesus, "I have come that you might have life and life more abundantly." The thief comes to steal and kill and destroy through lies, through saying that sin doesn't matter, hell doesn't exist, or saying sin does matter, hell does exist, but religion will save you. Just try harder. Be more religious. The thief comes to steal and kill and destroy, but Jesus alone, by grace, through faith, will save you. Look to Jesus and you'll be saved. Look to his love upon the cross. Look to the empty tomb. Look to him as the one mediator between God and men, and you will be saved, sir. Yes. No, I said no Christian has obeyed Jesus and harmed another man. No, Jesus didn't teach that we should harm people in his name. Yes. People have abused the name of Jesus and harmed people in that name. But Jesus didn't teach that. Yes. Well, Muhammad did. Quite differently. Muhammad did harm people. And he taught people to do so. Jesus, though, fully God, fully man, crucified because he loved us, was crucified, was buried, and he rose again on the third day, conquering sin and death, so that we don't have to go to hell. I'm arguing with it, sir, not against it. No, sir, I care about you. I care about all these folks. I care that they would not go to hell in their sins. And sin is real. God makes the rules. And friends, when we break them, God is holy, 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 and he will judge us as sinners. As it says in Hebrews 9:27, "It's appointed unto man once to die, and after this, the judgment." We're all going to stand before God, our Creator, and if we stand before him outside of the grace, mercy, love, and forgiveness of Jesus Christ, we will perish in our sins. But the good news is that sinners can be saved. For there's no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. But in the name of Jesus, there is salvation. In fact, his name means salvation. It means Savior. The love of God is manifest in Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. He gave him upon the cross. He was crucified. He was buried, and he resurrected on the third day. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the good news of the gospel, friends. That's the good news of God's love. And I'm so glad that gentleman stopped by to magnify the love of God, to draw attention to it, so we could speak of it and celebrate it. Look to Jesus. Look to the love of God in Jesus Christ, his cross, his empty tomb, and his role as the one mediator between God and men, and be saved, friends.